Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video, I'm going to study about articular sensory nerve supply to the glenohumeral joint and acromioclavicular joint capsule. I'm going to review this article by Dr. Philip Peng. Professor Philip Peng is working at the Toronto University and a great researcher, instructor, and professional pain doctor. He is full of energy when he teaches, and I'm so proud of him. It is my great honor. He is a good friend of mine.
But it wrap around give a nerve, so I think
This illustration and model are bird's eye view of right shoulder. Note clavicle, acromion, scapular spine, and suprascapular notch. This image is the bird's eye view of right shoulder, but I'm going to flip over the image to match the original article. Look in the direction of the shoulder: anterior, posterior, lateral, and medial. This is the clavicle shadow, and he removed it. Look at the coracoid process, acromion, scapular spine, supraspinous fossa, suprascapular notch, sphenoglenoid notch. He drew a line between suprascapular notch and sphenoglenoid notch and marked a red dot in the midpoint of the line. Suprascapular nerve passed deep to transverse scapular ligament, and suprascapular nerve divided into medial trunk and lateral trunk. The mean distance of the bifurcation of a suprascapular nerve from the midpoint of the line connecting the suprascapular and sphenoglenoid notch was 1.07 cm. The lateral trunk coursed along the floor of the supraspinous fossa to the sphenoglenoid notch. Glenohumeral joint capsule was innervated by articular branches that originate from the lateral trunk. To provide a summary of the innervation of glenohumeral joint, the capsule was divided into four quadrants: posterior superior, posterior inferior, anterior superior, and anterior inferior. They found that posterior superior quadrant was innervated by suprascapular nerve. Posterior inferior and anterior inferior was innervated by the axillary nerve. Anterior superior quadrant was innervated by subscapular nerve. Let's close a look at the cadaver dissection image. I heard that it took 80 hours for one cadaver dissection. This is the innervation of AC joint and posterior superior quadrant of the glenohumeral joint. Look in the direction of the shoulder: anterior, posterior, lateral, medial. This is the clavicle shadow. The clavicle was cut. Note the coracoid process, acromion, scapular spine, transhumeral ligament, and underlying suprascapular nerve main trunk. Blue color bars indicate the articular branch of the glenohumeral joint. The articular branch is not a single branch. There are many branches. The articular branches to glenohumeral joint originate from the lateral trunk of suprascapular nerve. Brown bars indicate the acromial branches. The acromial branches originate from the lateral trunk of suprascapular nerve. Under the anterior inferior surface of the clavicle, lateral pectoral nerve runs laterally, supplying the AC joint. This is the innervation of anterior superior quadrant of the glenohumeral joint. This dissection image is the anterior view of the scapula, glenohumeral joint, humerus head, and proximal humerus. Look in the direction. Note the subscapularis, coracoid process, long head of biceps tendon, posterior cord, axillary nerve, radial nerve. Purple color bars indicate superior nerve to the subscapularis. Magnified image shows details of articular branches, superior nerve to subscapularis, and axillary nerve innervation of the anterior joint capsule. Let's look at the other image. It shows details of articular branches, superior nerve to subscapularis, and axillary nerve innervation of the inferior joint capsule. Close observe the subscapular nerve in relation to coracoid process. These branches are located just below and medial to coracoid process. In summary, since most of the rotated cuff pathologies are supposed to locate in the superior posterior and anterior superior quadrant, I am stressing the articular branches from the lateral trunk of suprascapular nerve and superior nerve to subscapularis. An AC joint receives double sensory nerve supplies from the lateral trunk of suprascapular nerve and a acromial branch from the lateral pectoral nerve. Superior nerve to subscapularis supplies the anterior superior aspect of the joint capsule, and it is located just under the coracoid process. I fabricated articular branches with wires in the plastic scapular model according to Professor Philip Peng's research. Note the lateral trunk of suprascapular nerve. Purple wires are articular branches from the lateral trunk. The purple wires are branches of superior nerve to subscapularis. Next, I simulated the needle approach to the articular branches. This is the model of needle approach to the lateral trunk of suprascapular nerve. This is the model of needle approach to the superior nerve to the subscapularis. And then put things on the CM guidance and measures the CM angles and found the optimal CM view for each procedure. This is the model of the needle approach to the lateral trunk of the suprascapular nerve. This is the model of needle approach to the superior nerve to the subscapularis. And finally, we published this technique in the medical journal. Thank you for watching. See you in the next case of clinical practice of articular branch of the shoulder.